Kia ora, tēnā koutou, hello and welcome back to another episode of Thaumcraft 4.2 with Birdtross. We're here on the second level where I've implemented a lot more of the Nitor as well as putting in all of the platforms, and we also did some work during one of my recent live streams on this little mushroom island here. It'll eventually be an island floating, you know. So yeah, we've got a wood thing right here, and I also decided to build this out of mushroom blocks just because I thought, well, it's a mushroom island, we might as well try and incorporate them somehow. Still need to work on the redstone, it's not how I would like. Still need to work on this thing, it's not how I would like, but it's a start. We also need to move it a little bit as well. I just arbitrarily built the arcane board there because that was, I think, about the same. It's like right there. If you've got the water glass, yeah, that's where I built it based on that. But we need to move it because the I basically want the platform, this platform, to come out into the middle of the island, which is sort of that area there. So we need to move this entire thing over a couple of blocks to make it look a little bit nice. And we also need to move that farm back, move this melon farm, probably even move those farms as well. They don't even need to be on this level. They could be anywhere in the base, to be honest. They could be way down in the mine because they have the magic mirrors. We'll keep them around, though. But today what we're going to be doing to start off is taking a tour of Moonshine Factory 3.0, actually. Yeah, this thing is pretty beast. So we built this during another one of the live streams. Holy cow, I talked about during or after that Moonshine episode if I was going to rebuild this a little bit smaller and cooler, and I said that I wanted to have all the centrifuges right next to each other. That's happened. Holy cow. Look at this thing. It is so massive. I can't even believe that we built this thing. It took about 2.5 hours, I think. It uses about 2 stacks more essentia tubes, so it's not as efficient in terms of essentias being moved around. You know, sort of having to go like I just moused. So it does take a little bit longer for the machine to work, but it's, you know, it's way smaller laterally. And so we're going to be doing a couple of basic things today, such as moving all of this McGubbins right here. This golem's actually going to be like, hey-o, I need to put stuff there, so we better go ahead and get in there, get our torture rod, and select you would be a good plan. Yeah, stop. Wow, okay. Oh, torture rod. There we go. So stop servicing that, please. And he'll just be like, oh, okay. Okay, sir, I'm going back. So now that we've got that guy out of the way, we can go ahead and move this. I'd like to put this in the center. Well, actually, that should be one of the last things that we need to do. I actually want to do something a little bit here. So you guys won't have noticed now, but one of the major differences I noticed when this thing was going, man, my brain. I noticed when this was going that we only have one centrifuge for Messis. And a lot of Messis was getting backed up in here, up to the maximum 32. So that was just slowing the whole system down. So what I've done is put in 3 centrifuges for Messis right here. And the Messis breaks down into Eruba and Umanus. So I've got 2 for those. And then I've got 2 centrifuges for a Weektus as well. I was considering doing a 3rd, but there's going to be 1 change where hopefully we can avoid that. And the same thing has been happening here to the Farmes. It generates 1 Farmes for every wheat. And 1 centrifuge isn't enough. It's getting backed up in the alembic as well. So I would like to come in here, and actually what we need to do is move this entire setup over. Unfortunately, gonna have to break this thing. I did make a backup before proceeding with today's episode, so have no fear in that regard. But yeah, so I guess this just gives people a little bit of an insight into how exactly these things got built. So on the top here, we've got the 2 outputs are here and here. They're basically all the places they can be. And this one's weak to us and just goes off that way. And this one was Wakwas, which is going to need to move a bit, actually. I should just need to be able to replace the. I wonder if I should. Yeah, I think I would need to get rid of this, actually. So let's get you out of the way. Let's move you and just put a normal pipe into here. Okay, that's going to need to connect like that. Oh, that was weird. Anyway, so we need to get some arcane bellows down here. I'm going to need to make another arcane bellows now, because that wasn't the plan. Like that. So that's going to... We also need to get the 2nd farm as one. get a centrifuge down, we're going to need to put that right here. So the idea is these are buffers, right, by the way, they only have a suction of one, so they can only pull things right that they're connected to. So this is two blocks away, it can't pull the essentia out of the centrifuge, so we need to put the bellows on here. That's the idea there. Okay, so yeah, we've got those two going in there. Now the whack horse is going to be, it's going to go into here as well, so we need to pull the whack was out of here. So basically all this stuff needs to move. This was the Perditio in there. There's the ire as well. Those are going to need to move over a little bit. No, actually the whack was can stay right here, I suppose. It doesn't need to move, I don't think. Now that should be okay right there. And let's get... I'm just trying to think this out a bit. I think, yeah, we need to get another filter tube with a Farmes file. So let's go up to the filing cabinet, I've called it, get it, because there's files in the filing cabinet. Hello, anyone? Right, let's get our labels as well, and that should be good. We're also going to need the whack course, just to redo that. So while I'm thinking about it, let's get that down as well. That's right here, because I broke the pipe. We're going to need one for the centrifuge, just to type the suction. Awesome. Yep, go down. Go down. I also need to work on the platform area for this bit as well. I haven't really thought about the design for that yet. We're going to need to move that. Yeah, I said that already. Alright, so you need to be a filtered tube. So what I was doing is sort of doing that. And then I can just come in with this. And that should work just fine in terms of drawing stuff out of the alembic, because it goes through those two restricted tubes there. Right, but that's all good. And now that needs to go. We need another centrifuge here. Let's just go ahead and build the second centrifuge just to kind of visualize this a little bit. Get our buffer in place. Awesome stuff. And that can pretty much do what it was doing here. It should actually just be able to go forward and down, to be honest. Yeah, like this. Don't really need to actually do too much, so... that's good. And then this can connect right there. Bink. Nice. Right, so now that's the Wackwas one done, though. We need to actually send Wackwas in there. And to do that, we could put this in and get rid of those. There's been a lot of hammering of these pipes with the wand, by the way. They're all pretty much buttoning up next to each other. So the Wackwas comes in there. And that's got weak tools that goes out. We'll send the weak tools out the top like this. And that connects up again just fine. What we need to do is set this buffer edge on red mode. There we go. Let's type the suction. And we need to send the workhorse down here. That needs to go through two restricted tubes. So we come down here and do that. Like so, and that needs to go into this jar as well, so get that on there, and then that can just come down, and pretty much they should just connect like this. What are you? Oh, you're the old whack-wash tube. Okay, let's get rid of that. Kind of moved it over one block is all that really happened. Right, so the whack-wash tank is right there, so we'll bring this in like so. Okay. And this just needs to come down like that. Don't connect to my Farmes network. And Bob's your uncle. She's good to go. We might actually be able to... yeah, we might actually be able to save a couple of tubes here by moving the entire thing up one block. And just do that. That should work okay. Yeah, I think that'll be okay. That is the... that's in a nutshell how the system works. Now this is fogging up, and I know why it's fogging up. The reason is because the suction there is 1, and the suction there is 32. So we've got a suction conflict. The weak tools centrifuges can't pull the weak tools out of there, because the suction right there is 1, and then this next block would be 0. So what we need to do is we need to get an essentia pump in here, and this is also going to help as well, because I noticed while this machine was running, it was sort of... the weak juice was surging, if you understand my meaning. So what I'd like to do is implement some kind of little system, probably just even like right here. What have I broken? What have I broken? I broke two pipes. Okay, I broke the mortuus. I think it's called mortuus, by the way, because there's two U's in there. But we need to get the mortuus label going. Need to remember to do that. And what I wanted to do is have a buffer, like the essential buffer network right here, so that, which hopefully will smooth out the system a little bit. We also want to type the suction. Do I have a filtered pipe for that? No. I'm going to need another filtered pipe. Can I squidge through? There we go. So let's head over here and get another filtered pipe as well as that mortuus file. That's right over here. And another filtered tube right here, please. Let's just bring the whole lot. Why don't we? Head back down. Apologies, guys. A few guys were looking for some sort of cool new Thaumcraft thing to do. We're just doing a bit of building, just to kind of sit back and relax a little bit with the Thaumcraft today. I'm kind of having a little bit of trouble, honestly. A little bit of trouble of finding new things to actually do here in Thaumcraft, by the way. So perhaps it is getting time to start installing these add-ons. Would be kind of a good idea. But perhaps before we do that, we will... Where'd this go? Oh, this is weak to us. Perhaps what we'll do is finish off the research. So that might be a good idea to do next episode. Just finish off the research. That is fogging up over there. I want to see what's going on. Why are you fogging up? Let's have a look. I don't know why this would be fogging up. So we've got 29 untapped there, 28 white cross. Oh, right, that's right. I didn't do this to red mode. Silly me. And so that should solve that problem. See, things like that are the sort of things that stop systems like this from working. So that's all in. And I've got the buffer there. Now I need to make bellows. That's what I also needed to make. But yeah, we need to get that. Oh, I needed weak tooth as well. The weak tooth file. Dang it! A lot of back and forth. That's fine. That's fine. It's fine. This is the real deal, guys. This is what it takes to make these systems. There is just a lot of back and forth. Because I'm a forgetful guy. Alright, but that's that thing. And we're also going to need another arcane bellows. I've had to make two of these. I thought I needed just the one today. I'm starting to run a little bit low on those air shards. I might have to do some mining, proper mining, and spelunking and stuff to get some more air shards. Alright, we need more of these guys. And we also need a little bit of leather. Just a hair. Just a... Well, if hair was leathery. Leather was hairy. Anyway, let's get those in. I think that's like that. You right there. And four of those. Oh, not quite. There we go. Just set that charge back up. That's going to take too long for the YouTubes. So back this way. Yeah, we're already using a bunch of these arcane bellows on this project. But I really do want to get this thing working properly. And we want this in here. I did label it. Oh, not quite. And boop. There we go. So that should smooth the suction over. So basically any of the suction that generates in this thing should now sort of... any weak tooth anyway should accumulate in here. Like, it sort of surges and these two can keep up with it, as I've already said. And so hopefully it'll sort of pull in here a little bit and then get drained out, is what I'm trying to say. Surge. You know, I've already explained. Holy crap. Brain is going for a dazzle-razzled. But now what we need to do is get this machine up and running. And to do that, all we've got to do is bonk this golem down. And, oh no, he's not going to do the right thing because I have... moved that thing, so hold it right there, little guy. We've actually got to move this as well, which means we need to get the Messis and Farmez files down as well. Yeah. So now that we've added a new centrifuge, that actually makes this odd-numbered, which actually works out. We've got one on this side, but I think if you go over here, there's two on this side. So it is odd-numbered, and there's an even amount of a centrifuge. Perhaps what I could do is get rid of one of these jars that we've got doubled up, like we've got two paraditios, a couple of terras, you know, that kind of stuff. But Anyway, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Because that's the eighth one in. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You are the middle, my friend. Congratulations. So we want to put our new alchemical furnace right here. Like so. Hopefully this is in range of that wheat chest. It might be, but it might not be. We might have to work around it if that's the case. But anyway, let's get those on, and we also want to type them right now. So let's head back over up here and get the Messies and Farmers. Messies and Farmers. Yeah, what I was doing when I was building this is I actually just took the files down there with me. I had and just put them in a work chest, but we should be okay to just leave them up here. There we go. Alright. Hello. Are you ready to be typed? You better be. So we'll stick the farm as up top just like it was before. And the Missy's like that. And I think I'm going to take my sentient tubes and take them around the back this time like that. So let's bring this down and take it into the floor. Let's see, so which one of these lines was which? This is Messies right here. Okay, well we'll just hook this one up fairly straightforward. You like that, that's good. And the Farmes on the other hand. Well, we might just do this one slightly differently. We'll probably just, you know, just bring it down right in front of it, like that. That seems to work just fine, doesn't it? Or maybe we want to separate them a little bit just to save me the hassle of having to, you know, wrench them with my wand to stop them, you know, connecting together. I get rid of that. We have an arcane... what are they called? Arcane lamp. There we go. We have one of those up here, so that's all good for that. So get in here. Oh, and that's going to need to go under a little bit to connect up to that, alright. So, okay, we're just going to have to... we'll just do something like that. There we go. And let's jump up over here. Right, so that's just going to need to be moved down a little bit. Just up like this. Nice one. Easy. Right, so there's the system reconnected up. Obviously, we're going to need to put a bunch of water glass in here. There was a bit of talk in the live stream as well that we could do something behind the wall there, and I think that's quite a nice idea. Might throw some redstone lamps in there. Do something a little bit interesting to shake it up as far as the design goes, but that is pretty much the first real permanent, well, I guess the second real permanent setup here in the alchemy lab. Now, the edible that's right here, I was considering plugging this into our lamp of growth system, but I don't think I'm going to do that, actually, just because then that would prevent basically the rest of this system from working, and getting aspects out such as spiritus and stuff like that is really nice. Well, actually, having said that, all that the erba breaks down into is terra and victus, isn't it? That's something to think about. But anyway, let's go ahead and reinitiate the system. Now you need to be put down and tortured to see what's going on. Yeah, that's not going to work out, my friend. Oh. Okay, we're going to need to put a block there just to say, sorry, man. Okay, look, get you there. Alright. Let's try that now. Okay, is that going to work? Or is that too far away? It looks to be too far away. Oh, there's some wheat right there. Perhaps what we can do is move this system around a little bit. I think I'm going to go ahead and take a quick break. And what I'm going to do is move the cactus and the wheat chests. And hopefully that'll make them close enough. So we'll be right back once that's done. And welcome back. The wheat has been moved over to here. So now let's see if our wheat buddy can go ahead and work with that. Have you been... oh. Should I remove everything from this container or something specific? Okay, you haven't been set up. Right, we'll move stuff over here, bro. Please? Please be far enough. Please be close enough. It's not like it's moved that far. There we go. It took a while to update there. I think that's actually a setting that you can change. But alright, oh, there's no stuff in there. I think I wanted to get Phil set up as well. Apparently I didn't do that. Alright, Phil. Apparently I did not get you to move stuff into here either, so you can move along. So he should be doing that as well. And now we're waiting on Phil. Oh, and you're falling down there, aren't you? I don't have any blocks on me. I put my blocks away. But alright, the machine is now running. Go ahead and burn. Alright, so now that those things are going up, the machine is spooling up. I don't think it's actually going to start processing farm maize until this kind of fills up. But because this thing is working so gosh darn quick, that's going to be a while. You see how it's sucking the macease out as soon as it's ready? That's exactly what we want to see in the entire system come into life in a beautiful cacophony of sounds getting cut out. Kind of interesting. There are apparently too many sounds for Thaumcraft to handle, a problem that has been plaguing the series recently. Okay, is that... that should start processing Thumez now, I hope. Thumez is not... still not escaping. It should be coming through. Why is it not going through? Can it not suck? Let's see. The suction, please. So the suction on that should be 0. So that is 29. So yeah, that's definitely working. It's definitely enough suction over there, so... I noticed that this was happening during the stream as well, but it should be up and running now. The piping is pretty much what I did for the rest of the build. Oh. Yeah, you seem to be getting out of there just fine, so we'll go ahead and leave you be. Let's go ahead and turn this golem off, though. Hey, man, let me whack you into submission. No, I'm sorry. Nope. Nope. You gotta stop clicking on them with this guy. You learn that pretty quick, so throw that back in there. Righto, and I also saw a suggestion in the comments of the last episode. I can't believe I didn't even think of this. In hindsight, I realized that Sensus and Walatus are probably some of the aspects that we want to go for, given the persona that we're going for on the channel. They're probably going to go for Sensus, though, just because it's a little bit more obvious that that's us. So let's head over to our two banners that we've got put up in place as well. And they also said that the Pech like anything with Lucrum in them, basically. So let's go ahead and take a look at the Thaumonomicon in a bit. Wow, that actually does look quite nice. Kind of nice and highlighted. Very cool. Yeah, but they also said they take Lucrum, so that's what I just said. So Thaumonomicon, let's get that ready and then head up here. Where is that? So yeah, you just shift click, as the Thaumonomicon said, to get rid of that. In that goes. Nice and easy with the banners, bannerisms. Oh, and I put that down to the mining level as well, which is kind of good. But what does the Thaumonomicon say about Sensus? Let's have a look. Lucrum, sorry. Lucrum is back this way, though. Just passed it. Right, so it takes anything that's on this page. Gold coins, huh? Yes. Oh, and as well, that's right, because during one of those live streams, I actually gave the Pech a diamond block, and he gave us our very first rare treasure. I was wondering about this. I was just like, but there's common and uncommon. Where's the rare one, man? And I have been very interested in seeing what is inside this bag. I have no idea what's in there. It could be anything. Let's go ahead and pop this baby open and have a look. So we've got 30 coins and a bottle of enchanting. Well, that's actually a little bit of a letdown, to be honest. So much work on such little stuff. Well, I've been tempted to go ahead and throw him the block of emerald, pretty much the thing that's got the most in it that we can find. Is there anything that has more in it, though, that we could give him? Yeah, so there's 33 in there. That's pretty much the highest. I'm expecting a fantastic reward, sir, given that the block of diamond had 27 there from just what I saw. Sensus. And there's two of these guys now, by the way. Oh, the night approacheth, though, so that means whiffs. Oh, and as you can see, the glass has changed. I installed Optifine, so that has increased the performance. As you have been able to notice by now during the video, I can look over here and still have 30 FPS, which is kind of nice. Just factory settings for Optifine there, which is really nice. Hop on over to the bed and sleep the night away. Oh man. Yep. Jump up there, come on! Let's go and see what a block of emerald will give our little peck buddies. I'm hoping something good here. But you never know. And I think both of them are still friendly. Let's go ahead and find out though. Perhaps we have to make them friendly again. No, they've still got green things. Alright, a block of emerald. This could be great or bad. We'll find out. Ooh! Okay, we got a aqua ring, we got golden armor and iron armor. Yeah, but two silverwood saplings, though. That is pretty nice. That is pretty nice, and this guy's still friendly as well. I'm not sure if it matters who you give it to, but anyway, that's the pick trading for today. I hope I didn't just do a very bad thing there by giving them an extremely lucrum intensive item there, but two silverwood saplings, that's definitely not to be scoffed at. That brings our total up to 6, which is fairly nice. We're also growing the magical forest. That mana bean farm will be rebuilt pretty soon. This one's actually almost completely filled out. There's just a couple of blocks here in the corners to do, and then that will be done-skis, and we can throw down probably a third, and yeah, we can get started with the mana bean farm. But that will have to be in the next episode, because we're all out of time for this one. I hope that you guys enjoyed the episode as well as the base updates. Leave your comment suggestions and other feedback in the comment section below. Thank you very much for watching. Kia kaha, and I'll see you in the next episode. Nope.